Iranian forces in Syria have launched missiles at the Israeli military in the annexed Golan Heights region, Israel's army has confirmed. An Israeli air defense spokesman said about 20 rockets were fired by Iranian Quds forces at the Jewish state's defensive line in the area, which has been occupied by Israel since 1967. IDF spokesman Lieutenant Colonel Jonathan Conrias later confirmed that reports that no one has been injured and that defense systems intercepted some of the missiles. He said that Israeli forces had responded, adding, "The IDF sees this Iranian attack on Israel with sovereignty. This event is not over." Fighter jets have also been seen flying over the area, which lies near the Syria's southern border, according to the Britain-based Syrian Observatory for Human Rights. Shortly before the suspected strikes on the Golan Heights, reports within Syria claimed that Israel had attacked targets in one of the provinces south of Damascus. This comes after missile strikes last night were attributed to Israel, following reports of irregular activity of Iranian forces in Syria. The Israel Defense Forces has deployed Iron Dome missile defense systems in Golan Heights and in northern Israel in preparation for a retaliatory strike. Tuesday's strikes represents an immediate escalation in tensions in the region after the United States President Donald Trump walked away from the 2015 nuclear agreement that Barack Obama struck with Iran. Following America's withdrawal from the deal, Saudi Arabia's foreign minister said his country would develop nuclear weapons if Iran restarted its nuclear program. Known officially as the JCPOA, the so-called Iran deal was designed to curb Iranian nuclear ambitions while in return easing the sanctions crippling its country. Israel, which almost never confirms or denies airstrikes in Syria, did not comment on Tuesday's attack. Whatever the case may be, the situation between Israel and Iran is getting worse by the minute. Meanwhile, mainstream media is not even talking about it. They're simply talking about the fake, phony Russian collusion story on CNN and the rest of the phony mainstream media. We'll keep you updated. Leave your comments below this video. Thanks for watching.